My name is Dolores Bueno López. I am actually doing my PhD thesis in science material in the University Autonoma of Barcelona.
And what is the topic of your dissertation?
The topic of my dissertation is we are studying a capsules, liposomes, which are made of lipidic materials, and we try to encapsulate different proteins or molecules in order to treat some diseases.
And what is the purpose of the dissertation?
The purpose of my dissertation is to study the chemical and physical properties of our liposomes, because with changing a little things like the composition of the ratio between the components, we are changing the final properties of our nanocarrier and the nanomedicine. So my topic is not nanomedicine, but science material. So at the end, we want that the application is to nanomedicine, but we are in a very basic level studying the properties. We want to reduce the doses, also to reduce the side effects of the treatment, and to functionalize the superficie of our nanodrug in order that it goes to the target more specifically. So we are studying the chemical and physical properties of these capsules, but our aim is that it can use in rare disease to do nanomedicine.
And what kind of disease are we speaking about?
There are rare disease, so they have a low incidence in the population, so they don't have a lot of resources to investigate in such diseases. So I am proud and happy that in my group we are dedicating to investigate that. Those diseases that I speak of, Fabry disease and Sanfilippo syndrome, are both about the lack of an enzyme, a protein that inside our cells is in charge of degrading some metabolites that are like waste of the cell. So if this protein lacks, these residues and metabolites are starting to accumulate in the cells, causing several symptoms and leading to these diseases.
And why is it that difficult to find a treatment or to put this enzyme into the patient? What is the challenge?
The challenge is to avoid the degradation of the enzyme and to really focus the treatment in the zones in the body that has to make the action.
And why did you want to become a researcher?
Well, I think that when I was little, when I was a teenager, I was impacted by some diseases like Alzheimer, that in my home I have, well, my great-grandmother and also my grandmother now has this disease, so it impacts me how a person can lose all its her memories and became, well, a child, kind of. So I feel that science can change that, and science was the solution to improve the life of people that are suffering. So I think that influences my way of thinking.
Why are you so passionate about science? What is so fascinating for you?
That it can really explain the world where we live and give us answers, and also that with that answers we can change the world, because we can apply this answer and make the technology. I really hope that science will make us better humans.
And in which way?
In the way that we are going to have more knowledge, and I expect that this makes us really wise, and that we can avoid wars and all these kind of things, because we are in a higher level. Well, this is a a futuristic, a very, very long futuristic hope, but I would like to see that science really can change our lives for better. Not only in curing the illness, but also to making us more better persons.
And what would you like to change in science?
Well, I have a kind of romantic way about science. I think that science is an accumulative knowledge that all we make. So it should be open source and free access for all the people in the world.
And what do you like doing when you are not working on research?
I really like speaking about my research, but speaking in a way that my mother or my grandmother can understand what I am talking about. Because I so really like my job that I want people to understand that joy that I have, that passion that I have for what I am doing. So in my spare time, I have a blog, or I collaborate in different blogs or platforms.
Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
I would love to see me in Africa, working maybe in a small lab, but working in soil chemistry in order to do better agriculture in this zone. So that's my dream.
Thank you very much, Dolores.
Thank you. I like a lot this conversation.